There he is. Hey, mate. The Age Meister. How are you?
Oh, honey, I'm so happy you're here. Thanks for coming on the show. We're so excited to have you.
Yeah, about that. You know, I want to be on that couch more than anything, James. There is a slight problem. My mum's here. She says the only way that I can get on the show is if you win her approval.
These have traveled the world with me. These have been my shape and sunglasses of choice for pretty much the longest time. One, because it's really tough to find glasses that fit my gigantic head. Two, ones that complement me, I think. These are the larger size because the small ones look like I'm just wearing these like bottle caps. So these work really well. Last one. How did Henry Golding meet his wife? I'll make this one quick. She stopped me in the middle of the dance floor of a club in Singapore, New Year's Day, so 1:01:11. She stopped me and said to me, "Why haven't you said hello to me yet? I'm leaving in the next couple of days. You'll never ever see me again. What are you gonna do about it?"
James, stop. Stay there. Breakout, but Henry, we're gonna get right to it.
Please.
How old were you when you first looked into the mirror and realized you were beautiful?
You know what? I'm not gonna answer that question. I'm just gonna say how amazing Anthony's energy is. Like, this is the first time I've been.
I'm a huge fan of perfumery, fragrances. There's a few that I continuously buy. One of them, Le Labo Santal 33, really classic. But my list, I've literally got like three on my hit list. Many from Frederic Malle, who is a Parisian perfumer. Number one, Portrait of a Lady. Number two, Musk Ravageur. My fourth must-have on the list is Tom Ford Black Orchid, as well as Neroli. It always kind of reminds me of the times of traveling in like Positano and places.
The first I think I ever got was this Cartier Pasha Extra Large Moon Face. A little bit more classic, not too showy. Cary Grant of watches.
All right, first up. What Henry Golding? So let's have a look. What languages does Henry Golding speak? I can only speak like one language, and that's pretty much English. Very broken Bahasa Melayu, which is from Malaysia. But growing up in Southeast Asia, you kind of pick up a little bit of Chinese, a little bit of Indian, a little bit of Bahasa fluently, just one language. So this one makes a lot of noise. Leather jackets. I am forever sort of living in leather jackets. This one, it's a beautiful, I think it's calf leather. I know, touchy subject. But yeah, I have a tremendous amount of sort of leather jackets, everything from, this one's again, Dolce & Gabbana, Belstaff, do some fantastic sort of motorbike jackets, as well as sort of outdoor jackets that I love. Barbados has a fantastic fit as well. But I'm loving these Dolce & Gabbana right now because they have a great fit and great colors. Don't be afraid to sort of step out of the whole black leather thing. Go for some color, spice it up. My love for leather jackets, I guess it stems from trying to look cool. Is that good enough a reason?
I think it serves its purpose when you give it after because you already gave it to her before.
Yeah.
Let's talk about your family for a second.
Please.
You know, let's talk about your heritage, your culture. Where are you from? How did this mixture happen?
So I'm from a tribe in Malaysia called the Iban. It's on the island of Borneo. My dad's English, Portsmouth. But I was born on the island itself. And traditionally, they were like back in the generational days, sort of headhunters and really sort of a fierce tribe. Mm-hmm. I remember going back as a kid and they live in these sort of communal, beautiful homes with sort of 15 to 20 houses in one stretch. So it's a very, very strong sort of community. I remember going back and there's no electricity. If you wanted like fresh meat, you'd have to go out to sort of get a pig or a chicken right. or anything. So very much sort of grassroots in that sense. Mm-hmm.
Does Henry Golding have tattoos? I have lots of tattoos. I come from a tribe in Malaysia called the Iban. And so I have a huge tattoo here. I got tattoos on my shoulder, my ribs, on the sort of the inside of my arms, not knowing that I was going to be an actor. So they are the bane of my existence when you need to cover them up. So you have to come in like 3-4 hours earlier. So probably no more tattoos.
First travel show, I thought I deserve something nice and a bit flashy. I think I spent my entire savings on this watch and was eating pot noodles for the rest of the rest of the month.
Does Henry Golding do martial arts? I had not done a tremendous amount of martial arts. I did a lot of sort of boxing and Muay Thai kind of growing up and stuff like that. So a foundational basis of martial arts, but they really put us through the ringer for Snake Eyes.
Cholula.
Hot sauce is a must with any meal. Not particularly Cholula. I do love Cholula.
I have like an Apple Watch too. Do I call that Steve? Like, is that, I don't know. Little Bentley, I like that. Cassius. That looks like a Cassius to me.
Snake Eyes and Storm Shadow brothers. They are absolute blood brothers. They've been sort of joined in ways that honor and duty can only bind men and women. And that is a bond that is unbreakable and is one of the most iconic relationships that flip-flop from hating to being an arch nemesis to fighting for the right cause, the same thing, back to hating each other and then hugging it out on sort of Christmas days and forgiving and forgetting.
You have an interesting character in your family, an uncle?
Oh my God.
Who used to fight alligators?
Yeah, my uncle, he is an absolute beast. You could send him out in the middle of the jungle with just like a knife and he'd come back with a pelt of like a bear or like a
right.
know, wolf sort of fangs hanging from him. But yeah, there was a story where to get to this longhouse, you would have to cross this rather large river, mm-hmm. Which is crocodile infested, because obviously.
Right.
And so there,
you can't leave like this. I need to do the show and you need to host it.
But what about your mother?
She says that you can't host the show. Not without this.
Wait, does this mean she approves?
She does.
Oh, I love you too. I mean, you know, that's just, let's be cool. Yeah, let's be cool. Do the show.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's be cool.
All right.
All right, let's do it. Yeah.
I guess it's this way, huh? Oh!